So students, in morning I explained the concept like which concept I explained, that is you can write the user defined functions, four types of user defined functions, and I did with explanation, and in evening videos I will explain the call by value or call by reference. So first let me tell you about the call by values. My computer screen is shared or not? Is it shared?
Shared. Yes. Okay.
Call by value. And then one more thing. Can you tell me who was writing, who was disturbing the class in the morning? Can you tell me? Because those who are disturbing the class, na, they basically they are not creating the problems for me. They are creating the problems for you also. Because you are here and you are here for a study, do not here for wasting your times. What is the aim of your? You are just wasting the data. The battery, you are that means wasting the times, but you are all things wasting and for gaining knowledge. But if you are not gaining, if you do not get the knowledge, then what is the aim of coming on time? So someone if disturbing you, then please you can stop to him or her. Okay, this is also your responsibility. This is,
yes sir.
This is not only the responsibility of a teacher. Okay.
I'm
talking about the real things. If you are a good student and if you want to study, then you should stop the disturbing element. Okay. Okay, so call by values I will explain. So basically call by values, let me take one real example. Suppose students, if you copy a movie to a pen drive, okay, and you give this pen drive to your friend and your friend copy this movie from pen drive to his computer, okay. So when he watched this movie, after some days he watched the movies, and after some time he deleted it. So can this will be deleted from your computer also? Can it will be deleted from your computer also? Reply me.
What?
I said, if you give a movie to your friend in the pen drive, and your friend is copied this movie from pen drive to his computer, so after watching this movie, he has deleted that movie from his computer. So if he has deleted from his computer, so can it will be deleted from your computer also?
I think it is no.
That why it is no, students? Why it is no? Because he has a separate copy of the movie. Separate copy means he has separate copy. You have separate copy. So why the deletion will be affected to your computer? I think it will not affect. Is it clear?
No, any change will happen.
Absolutely right. Absolutely. So the same thing is call by value. Let me explain it by one example. And student, I am damn sure you will not get the videos like in this manner, like relating with the practicals, relating with your real lives on YouTube or any school websites. I'm not just promoting to myself. You can go and check also. Then inform me, sir. If you got like this video, then please inform me. Okay. So what I was explaining, call by value. Okay, so call by value means if the values, that means if the movies is present in another computer and you are also having that that movie, and if he has deleted, then this movie will not be deleted from your computer. So I said this is the same concept of call by value. So let me explain call by value. Suppose I am passing 12, 13. So here should be int a comma int b. Is it right or not? Int a comma int b, because 12 goes to a and 13 goes to b. So this is compulsory to write. Is it clear or not? Because if it is not clear, then that will be a problem. Clear, students?
Yes, sir.
Clear. So suppose if I am doing like this, a equal to a plus 1, b equal to b plus 1, system dot out dot println. If I print a plus, this means space plus b. So what is the answer? Can anybody tell me the answer? And here is not any returning because the value is not returned. So that's why we are deleting. Can anybody tell the answer? If you can tell, do not waste your time. Tell me if you yes. Tell me yes. If you know, then you can tell no. Just immediate tell me. Students, do not waste your time, please. Many times I said to you, can you tell the answer or not? Just say something. Say this.
No.
You are saying no, but it is very easy, students. If I am passing 12, it goes to A. If I am passing 13, it goes to here. And what happened? A becomes A plus 1. That means 12 becomes 13. So A values become 13. And 13 goes
sir,
to
sir, answer is 27.
27? How you will get 27? Just see here.
Sir, 27 not.
Then... listen the answer. So 13 goes to here. So 13 becomes 14. So that means A becomes 13, B becomes 14. So here becomes, here you will get 13, then one is space, then you get 14. So 13 is space 14. Just see here the result. Missing? Missing return statement. Acha, I have written void. Array int, you must write here void because you are not returning anything. Just again run it. Okay, so this is run and let me compile it again. Just wait. Okay, so let me compile it. Oh, you got 13 and 14. 13 is space 14. Am I right or not? Am I right?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, very nice. So students, if I write here system dot out dot println, and one more thing I want to show you, if I write here int c equal to 12, d equal to 13, and I am passing here c comma d. Is it clear? I am passing here c comma d. There will be not any effect because c becomes c having 12 and d having 13. So students, if I am printing here c plus space and d, so can you tell me the answer right now? Can you tell me the answer? Can you tell me the answer? If yes,
12 is space 13.
What? Listen, it comes to here, object is created.
Then 14 is space 14.
Listen, then it call add method. Add goes to here and A becomes 13, B becomes 14. So here 13 is space 14. Then it come back to here and here it will print. This is the question. Here it will print 12 comma 13 or 13 comma 14. Which answer you will get? You will get this answer.
13 comma 14.
13 comma 14.
Yes.
I think no. Just see the answer.
12 comma 13.
See the answer. You will get 13 comma 14, 12 comma 13. How? Because the same concept I said to you, this variable is having separate copy. As you given the movie in the pen drive, so if that person deletes, if that person removed, if that person update that movie, then that will not be affect to this one. Okay, so it is having 12 and 13. So 12 and 13 will be here, even it is updating it. Okay, so it is updated by one, but it will not affect to here. The concept is clear right now or not? So this concept is called call by value. What is called?
Call by value.
Call by value. Is it clear to everyone? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next, I am going to call by reference. Call by reference. Call by reference. So, student, suppose listen my word, each and every word very carefully. Otherwise, you will not get anything. So, listen. Suppose, student, I kept a movie at one place. Okay, and I have the location. I have the location of that movie, and my friend is also having the location of that movie. So that means we do not. That means. If my friend is updating anything to that movie, then can it will affect to me or not? Can it will affect or not to me? Tell the answer. Tell the answer.
No.
It will affect. It will affect because we do not, we have the address. So if anyone will change the values on particular address, then that, because we also having that address, so that address will be reflected. So that is called call by reference. So that address will be reflected. Is it clear to everyone? Because you are not having the separate value. You are having the locations and you are changing anything to a particular location. Is it clear? You are changing to the thing at the particular location. So that location change their values. Suppose, let me make something. Suppose, saves. I have a value like 10 over here. I have 10. I have 10 over here. And my friend, suppose someone is having my friend, this one, and one person is also are having. Both are having the location of this one. This one Ramesh. Sorry. This one is Ramesh. And this one is Mohan. So if Ramesh is updating it to 11. So this 11 will be affected to Mohan or not? It will be affected or not?
Yes.
Affected. Right. So if Ramesh will have separate like 10 and it will have separate like 10. So if it is separately having 10, then what happened? It will change, then it will not affect. It will change, then it will not affect. But here the they will not have the separate value, they will have the memory locations. So if that value will be changed, then both the location will be affected. Okay, is it clear? Clear to you?
Yes, sir.
So that is called call by reference. What is called? Call by reference. Let me show you by the example. Suppose I have a member variable int a, okay, and just delete these all. Okay, and this is also not useful. Remove this also. This is an example of call by reference. Call by I reference. So students, if you have seen the videos which I suggested on yesterday, then I said to you, A is the member of object. So I can assign obj dot a equal to any values. Can I do like this or not? Can I do like this or not? Can I do, student? Student, please tell me, please. Can I assign a values to a in this way or not? Because a is the member of this object obj, so obj dot a equal to 19. So 19 goes to a. That means this a variables right now contains how many values? 19. Is it clear? Is it clear? Yes. You? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So students, let me show you one thing. Suppose I am ob. If I am calling the function and that function I'm passing the that particular object. So obj dot function name is add and I am passing this object. Object means we are passing the location, this particular object. So that means here we will have this object is which type? This is a Pramod Kumar type. So we will write like this, Pramod Kumar, and we write the obj1, any variables I can write. Just wait, I will explain everything if you give me 5 minutes more. Let me write. And if I do change like this, obj1 dot a, obj1 dot a equal to 15. Okay, and so this is right now 19. And I'm getting here right now, I'm just holding is 12. And this is, wait. System dot out dot println. If I print this, it will be written like variable static. Static in static, because I am writing in the static method. So static int obj dot add, and I will write here obj dot a, or I can directly write a, okay, obj dot a, because this is the variable of obj. Let me run it, compile this. Class compiled, no syntax error. So you will see the result. I do not have time, that's why I am just doing my practical very fast. 1:10 is time. Can you give me 5 minutes so that I can explain more? Can you stay here 5 minutes?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay, so student, let me show you. Suppose I have this, do not be confused in static. Static variable I will discuss in the next week, because this static variable are in your this chapter, in this chapter, same chapter. Okay, so the concept of static variable will be explained the next next week. So static int, I have a variable, and just think about from here, from here. So I have a int type variable that is containing 12, and what happened, I am changing anything. Suppose come from here, I made one object, and after that I am calling this method. So I'm calling this add method, and I'm you have studied like this, you have studied, you are passing 12, 13, but right now I am passing obj. So 12, 13 was which type? Which type was 12, 13? Can you tell me what was the type of 12? Just do me answer, please give me answer in me fast. What are the type?
Call by reference.
Oh, I'm asking about the type. What was the type of 12? 12 is which type? Student. 12 is which type? Float type? Character type? Which type? Which type of 12? Well, very, what can I say to? 12 is which type? Twelve is float type, character type, string type, which type? Which type, please tell me. You cannot give the answer, single answer. You don't know 12 is integer type. You cannot know 12 is integer type or not. Are you listening to me? I am very disappointed to teach you people. 12 is integer type or not? 12 is, yes. So if I will ask what is the type of OBJ, can you tell me OBJ is which type? OBJ is which type? Can you tell me? Can you tell me OBJ is which type? OBJ. Yes. OBJ is Pramod Kumar type. You don't know. If I said cow, cow is an object. So cow is which type? You said animal type, because the type is same as the class name. So what is the class name of object? Pramod Kumar. So what is the type of object? Pramod Kumar. Is it clear? Is it clear? So OBJ is a Pramod Kumar. So in the same way, when you pass here 12, 13, then you need to have a variable over here like this one. Int A, int B. You have this type of variable. So if I am passing a object of a Pramod Kumar type, so which type of variable you must have? Which type of variable you must have? You must have a variable of Pramod Kumar type. So I will write here, that's why I am writing here Pramod Kumar, and you can write the variable name, any variable name. Suppose I am writing here obj1. Okay, then after that I am changing the values of this variable 12. So obj, you know that by object we can change the variable. So obj1.a equal to 15. Right now this object is having variable change the variable a value to 15. So if I print the values obj dot a, then what you will get? Just print over here. You can write like this also. What you will get? Just see here. 15. So students, you are changing the variable here, and this is reflecting to here. Here also. So why it is reflecting? Because you are changing by the help of object, by the help of location. By the help of location. So that's why it is reflected to here also. So that's why the value becomes 15 over here. If this is not reflected, then you will get the answer 12, but you are not getting 12, you are getting 15. And you can also, are you getting my point or not? Are you getting or not?
Getting, sir.
Students, just raise your hands and tell me your, I will take 5 minutes more. Just tell me the questions, tell me the problems in this examples. I will explain your every doubt. One by one. Divya Chaudhary, what is the problem you are facing? Divya Chaudhary, tell me your problem, please. Divya Chaudhary.
In object.
Yes.
In data name types.
Data name types. So, you know, if I write, just you think, a object is always is of class name type. So what is the class name? What is the class name?
Parmod Kumar.
So what is the type of object? Which type is object? Pramod Kumar type. Is it clear?
Yes, clear.
Okay, Grijesh Shonkar, what is your problem? Okay, leave him. Gulsita? Mansi? Ritik. What is your problem in this solution, in this example?
Sir, if int a is equal to 12, then how it is printing 15?
What? Again, ask. Int?
If int a is equal to 12, how it is printing 15? I'm not getting.
Int a equal to 12. You are asking this? Okay, you are asking this. How it becomes, that means, 15.
Yes, sir.
Students, you know that if you you are passing this object, and this object is a Pramod Kumar type, so in the same way when you are writing int a, so a was int type, that's the same way this object is a Pramod Kumar type, so you need to have write here Pramod Kumar. So Pramod Kumar, then after that, any variable name you just like. Variable name, this is the object name. So if you are changing by this variable by object, so you know that the variable and methods are the members of the object. So you can change like this, object obj1 dot a equal to 15. So this 12 becomes 15 right now over here. So if you are going to print a here, then it do not print 12, because you change the values at the memory location, which memory location is shared by these two functions. Okay. Basically, you cannot say shared. You can say that. Just see here the example. Basically, in call by reference, you passed the memory location. What you passed? The changing is done at memory location. This memory location. Suppose the memory location is having 1001. So if any change is happening is this memory location, so can this will be reflected to Ramesh or Mohan or not?
It will.
So in the same way we are changing to the memory location, students. So that memory location will be the values are changed to that particular memory location. So that memory location is becomes the value of that memory location is becomes 15. So 15s will be affected to everywhere. Okay. So this 12 becomes 15 right now. Is it clear?
Yes,
so in your book, what it is written? In the pass by reference technique, the reference of the actual parameter is passed to the formal parameter. Remember that the reference denotes the memory location of a variable. Is it clear? That means this object represents the memory location of the variable. Is it clear? So you are changing the memory location variable's value. Okay. So actual parameter and formal, what are actual parameter? This is actual parameter, this is formal parameter, they both are having the same memory location. So if this represent the memory, when I said what I said, reference denotes the memory location of a variable. So this is reference, this is reference. So this is the, this represent the memory location. So if any changes is happened at the memory location, then that will be reflected to each and everywhere. Is it clear? So both actual parameter and the formal parameter represent the same memory location. Okay. So any changes done at formal parameter will also get reflected to the actual parameter. Okay, is it clear right now?
Yes, sir.
Also, you should study it from your book. Okay, and when we will meet in the next class, then I will explain it one more time. It will be good for you or not?
It will.
Is it clear?
Yes,